siding, windows, and gutters.
All right, we are approaching 5:43 already this morning, and once again, we're quiet outside. You can see visibility is good, even though it's still dark. Nothing really coming in on top of us right now, but that may be changing this afternoon. In fact, 15 degrees, it's certainly cold. Fortunately, though, the wind's pretty light out of the north at only 6 miles per hour. Other spots kind of vary depending on cloud cover. Less of that to the northeast has the temperature down to 10 in Carroll, but you go to the south and west, it's in the lower 20s. Right now from Omaha to Lincoln, back to Fremont, everybody kind of in the same boat there in the middle teens. All right, wind chill factors, not horrible because we don't have a lot of wind, but it still feels colder right now. Red Oak feels like -1 when you step out there. 6 above, that's the wind chill factor here in the metro. And you step out in Lincoln, it feels like a chilly 5 above there. All right, as we go from the airport south and east through Council Bluffs here on our exclusive Viper HD street level mapping, you can see what will become some of our busier intersections. Snow free right now this morning. We can take that back through the metro. The entire viewing area quiet this morning. We do have some clouds beginning to increase. In fact, most of that running from northwest to southeast there. Those clouds will thicken up, and eventually our next little weather system, it's not that strong, but it's going to race south and east right along the storm track here and potentially give us the possibility for some light snow and flurries this afternoon. Once again, the morning drive will remain quiet, just looking for clouds to increase. We slowly climb from the upper teens to low 20s through the afternoon, and then here comes the snow, and this model fairly bullish with it there. You can see temperatures in the upper 20s. As far as amounts, I think that track, again, probably from Columbus to Lincoln north and east, we're talking about a dusting to maybe an inch. So not a ton of accumulation, but the timing on that, you saw in our computer model, between about 3 and, say, 6 or 7 o'clock, that could certainly cause problems for at least the start of the evening drive. So keep that in mind. So that's in the forecast again this afternoon. The morning drive will be fine, just cold. Even maybe a few peaks of sunshine before the thicker clouds move in. 28 for the high with the southeast breeze at 5 to 15. Tonight then, after some flurries early, I think that little impulse moves to the southeast. That'll leave us with some clouds and 20 degrees. Tomorrow should be a little brighter in between weather systems at about 28. Still cold, and then the real cold shot of air comes in as we head from Friday night into Saturday morning. And this is interesting because this may back up that storm track a little bit to the west. That's key because with these northwesterly systems, a lot of times you get the heavier snow on the north and east side of that. So if it tracks a little more west of us, we'd have a better chance for snow. And this looks to be the strongest of all of these over the next couple of days. You can see snowfall projections, light to flurries down through our southwestern viewing counties. We'll likely get some accumulation here. And then some of our models, as you get up into northwestern Iowa, saying several inches of snow. So stay tuned for that. And that's an important forecast because I know a lot of us will be out celebrating Valentine's Day on Saturday night. For Sunday itself, the actual day there, if you decide to head out there, the morning flurries shouldn't cause too many problems through the day. 38 for the high. And one thing that has been very constant in this forecast, right now we look very warm, much warmer next week. 47 Monday. I think we're in the 50s on Tuesday, and then back in the 40s, still looking pretty good on Wednesday. So just a reminder as well, you can download Snowcast to your smartphone. Once again, it's an app, a winter weather app, kind of that depicts the snowfall amounts, where we're going to see the most. And we got a shot today and a shot Saturday. Neither one of these look to be major storms, but again, nuisance stuff, especially this afternoon, could cause some problems as that comes in right around the evening drive. All right, the time now, 5:46. It is a chilly 15 degrees outside. Stay with us. We'll have more right after the